In the last video, we learned how we can use segment routing traffic engineering policy to create a traffic engineering pass. Then we learned how to manually steer traffic over traffic engineering pass using Binding-SID. In this section, we would like to learn how traffic steering works automatically using BGP. This is the topology that we have used in the last section. If you remember, in XRE1, I created a segment routing traffic engineering policy or pass through XRE2, 4, 5, and then 6 with binding SID of 40,000. I have also created another policy for the same destination in XRE3. Then I enforce the traffic manually from XRV3 to be routed through XRV1, and then binding SID of 40,000, which route the traffic from XRV3 to XRV6 through XRV1, 2, 4, 5, and then 6 instead of direct pass XRV3, 5, and 6. However, in this section, I want to show how we can steer traffic through segment routing traffic engineering pass automatically using BGP protocol. Our topology is the same, but this time we have two customers, Raika and Company 1, Raika and Company 1, who are connected to the PE routers XRV1 and XRV6. Subnets belonging to Raika and Company 1 are advertised on the network via BGP, VPNV4 address family between XRV1 and XRV6. Raika is a gold customer which has paid more money, and Company 1 is a silver customer which has paid less money. How does automatic traffic steering work? There is a simple rule. When the next hop and color of a route, next hop and color of a route matches the endpoint and color of a policy, then the traffic match the route is automatically routed through the active segment routing traffic engineering pass associated with that policy. To better understand, in XRV1, I've created two policies. In XRV1, I've created two policies. Gold policy with endpoint 6666 and color 10, whose active traffic engineering passes through XRV1, 2, 4, 5, 6. The second policy is silver with the same destination 666 and color 20, whose active traffic engineering passes through XRV1, 3, 5, and then 6 this pass. It is normal that when we advertise customer routes in the network, we assign a tag or we mark customer routes equivalent to their SLA services. So in XRV6, I add color 10 for customer Raika subnets and color 20 for Company 1 subnets with extended community and then advertising through BGP. As you can see, here in XRV6, when I advertise the route, I advertise route through the route policy VPN before. In the route policy, I told if the destination is 192, 162, then the color is gold or 10, which is for the customer Raika. And when the destination is 192, 168, 3, Then the color is silver or 20. When XRB1 receives the roads, the next hop of roads are 666. And the color of the roads are 10 or 20, according to the customer. It means that the roads will be matched with the one of these two policies configured in XRB1, gold or silver with the same destination and color. So traffic matching these roads will be automatically steered through segment routing traffic engineering paths, which is active in the policies. We can expect that traffic from XRV1 and belonging to rival customer will be steered automatically through XRV2, 4, 5, and then 6, and traffic belonging to company 1 will be steered through XRV356 automatically. Now I would like to review the entire configuration first and then monitor engineering paths of the segment routing. My configuration is classified in 5 steps. In the step 0, ISIS and segment routing are activated in all routers. The configuration of XRV1 is displayed here. As you can see, ISIS is activated in all interfaces. The segment routing is activated with the command segment routing MPLS, and the prefix SID of loopback 0 of all routers is configured from 16001 to 16006. In the next step, VRF of Raika and Company 1 are created in PE routers, both XRV1 and XRV6, with their respective import-export route target, which for Raika Company is 1111 and for Company 1 is 12. Interface loopback 1 is assigned to Raika VRF and interface loopback 2 is assigned to Company 1 VRF. In the next step, BGP between XRV1 and XRV6 with address family VPNV4 is configured. The IP address of loopback interfaces belonging to customers VRF, VRF Raika, and VRF customers are redistributed into BGP and advertised through VPNV4 address family between XRV1 and XRV6. In the next step, route received from the customers in XRV6 are marked with their respective SLA service. Routes from Raika customers are colored with number 10 or gold, and routes from Company 1 customer are colored with number 20 or silver SLA. Then these colors are advertised with their routes through BGP with a route policy VPNV4. These routes are received in router XRV1 with the next hop address of 666 and color 10 or 20. In router XRV1, we have written already two segment routing traffic engineering policy. As you can see in the next step, one for endpoint 666 and color 10, the other for endpoint 666 and color 20 or silver. The first is gold and the second is silver. The preferred path of gold is through XRV 2, 4, 5 and then 6, and the preferred path of silver policy is through XRV 3, 5 and 6. Since these policies are matched with incoming route in XRV1, so the traffic matching the route will be automatically steered through traffic engineering paths configured inside the policy. Let's check the routes that are advertised through BGP first. We command show BGP VPN before unicast. As you can see, the routes are learned with their respective color. Now for the VRFRI call, subnet 2 with the color 10, and VRF company 1, subnet 3, color 20. With command show BGP VPN before unicast VRF, for example, Raika 192.168.2.0.24, you can see the detail of the receive route, including the color and if it is matched with the traffic engineering policy. As you can see, the color is 10 and it is matched with SR policy color 10 with binding SID 40,000, which is manually configured. Binding SID 40,000. Binding SID 40,000. Color 10. Binding SID 40,000. As you can see, the route 192.168.2.0 is matched against gold policy with binding SID of 40,000, which is configured manually. This bus binding SID is configured manually. But the route 192.168.3 is matched with the silver policy with dynamic binding SID. Silver, I have not configured a binding policy for the silver policy. So the binding SID is dynamic for the silver policy. You can check the dynamic binding SID associated with the policy with the command show segment routing traffic engineering policy. For the policy color 20 and endpoint 66, as you can see, binding SID is 24,009. This is the dynamic binding SID. 24,009. And also with the command show BGP VPN before unicast VRF company 1 and subnet 3, we can check whether this route is binded to the dynamic binding SID or not. 24,009. As you can see, segment routing policy is color 20 and the binding SID is 24,009. Binding SID 24,009. Also with trace route, we can ensure that traffic is in connection with the Raika and company 1 are routed via their respective traffic engineering paths. For example, trace route VRF Raika subnet 2 2456 and with binding SID of 40,000, which is mapped to 16,004, 5 and then 6, which is configured in the policy. 16,004, 5 and then 6. The pass is 2, 4, 5 and then 6. Also, we can check for VRF company 1, the subnet 3. Through 3, 4, 3, 5, 6. With the binding SID, dynamic binding SID 24,004 is the VPN label. 24,005 is VPN label. Check the VPN label, show So BGP, VPN, V4, unicast, dynamic binding SID is mapped to their respective SID configured in the policy 16,003, 5, and 6. But the 24,004 and 24,005 is the VPN label. You can check with show BGP VPN before unicast label. We have to check in XRV6. Show BGP VPN before unicast labels. Subnet 2, 24,005. Subnet 3, 24,004. 24,005. So the traffic are routed through their respective paths configured in traffic engineering paths or automatic traffic steering.